The Palace of Illusions by Chitra Banerjee Divakaruni. About the author. Chitra Banerjee Divakaruni is an Indian-American author, poet and the Betty and Jean McDavid Professor of Writing at the University of Houston Creative Writing Program. Divakaruni's works are largely set in India and the United States and often focus on the experiences of South Asian immigrants. She began her career as a poet and continues to write and publish poetry. She writes for children as well as adults and has published novels in multiple genres, including realistic fiction, historical fiction, magical realism, myth and fantasy. Her novel One Amazing Thing has currently been optioned by the Hollywood production company Gillen Group. Her short story collection, Arranged Marriage, won an American Book Award in 1995, and two of her novels, The Mistress of Spices and Sister of My Heart, as well as a short story The Word Love, were adapted into films. Divakaruni's novel The Palace of Illusions was a national bestseller for over a year in India and is a retelling of the Indian epic The Mahabharat from Draupadi's perspective. Critical analysis of the novel, The Palace of Illusions. The Palace of Illusions is a 2008 novel by award-winning novelist and poet Chitra Banerjee Divakaruni. It was released by Picador. In novel The Palace of Illusions, the tale is told entirely from Panchali's, better known as Draupadi, perspective. This, dubbed Panchali's Mahabharat, on the cover is a critical shift and impacts the retelling kaleidoscopically. Even though Draupadi is at the core of the story, her individual role in the original is almost incidental. In this version, she is the key protagonist and it is her voice that takes us through her birth from fire, her Swayamvar, her marriage to the Pandavas, her humiliation in the Kauravas' court, her years of exile, the actual war, and finally the ascent into Mount Meru towards Swaga. Divakaruni's choice to narrate the story from Draupadi's point of view offers a fresh and intriguing perspective on the Mahabharat. This allows readers to empathize with Draupadi, a character often relegated to a secondary role in traditional retellings. The novel excels in fleshing out Draupadi's character, portraying her as a complex and multidimensional figure with her own desires, flaws, and strengths. Through her narrative, readers witness her growth from a young girl with dreams and aspirations to a powerful queen embroiled in the politics and conflicts of her time. Divakaruni's portrayal of Draupadi is a strong, independent woman challenges traditional gender roles and highlights the injustices and constraints faced by women in ancient Indian society. The novel explores themes of agency, identity, and the quest for empowerment in a patriarchal world. The novel skillfully navigates the complex political landscape of the Mahabharat, presenting the various power struggles, alliances, and betrayals that shape the course of the epic war. It also delves into the moral dilemmas faced by the characters, forcing readers to confront questions of duty, righteousness, and the consequences of their actions. Divakaruni infuses the narrative with a profound emotional depth, capturing Draupadi's inner turmoil, passion, and vulnerabilities. The novel explores themes of love, loyalty, jealousy, and sacrifice, eliciting a range of emotions from readers as they become immersed in Draupadi's journey. While the novel offers a fresh perspective on the Mahabharat, it remains rooted in its cultural and mythological context. Divakaruni weaves in elements of Hindu mythology, ritual, and symbolism, enriching the narrative with layers of meaning and depth. Through Draupadi's story, the novel critiques the patriarchal norms and systemic violence that pervade ancient and contemporary societies. It prompts readers to reflect on issues of gender inequality, injustice, and the cyclical nature of violence. Divakaruni's prose is lyrical and evocative, immersing readers in the rich tapestry of ancient India. Her vivid descriptions, vivid imagery, and poetic language bring the world of the Mahabharata to life, creating a captivating reading experience. The novel grapples with the philosophical theme of fate versus free will, exploring the extent to which individuals can shape their destinies in the face of predetermined events. Draupadi's life is marked by prophecies, curses, and divine interventions, yet she continually asserts her agency and strives to assert control over her own narrative. Divakaruni skillfully navigates the tension between fate and free will, highlighting the moments of choice and agency that define Draupadi's character while acknowledging the forces of destiny that shape her journey. The novel offers a searing critique of war and violence, depicting the devastating consequences of conflict on both individuals and society. Draupadi's perspective provides insight into the human cost of the Mahabharata war, highlighting the suffering and loss endured by innocent civilians and combatants alike. Divakaruni does not glamorize war but instead exposes its brutality and futility, challenging readers to confront the moral complexities of violence and its impact on human lives. This anti-war sentiment underscores the novel's overarching themes of compassion, empathy, and the search for peace. The Palace of Illusions, by Chitra Banerjee Divakaruni, is a thought-provoking and beautifully crafted novel that offers a compelling reinterpretation of the Mahabharata through the eyes of its female protagonist. It engages with timeless themes and issues, making it relevant to contemporary readers while honoring the rich cultural heritage of ancient India. Summary of the novel, The Palace of Illusions. The Palace of Illusions, by Chitra Banerjee Divakaruni, is a richly layered narrative that offers a fresh perspective on the Mahabharata, one of the most revered Indian epics. The novel opens with Draupadi's birth, which is marked by a prophecy that she will change the course of history. Raised as a princess in the kingdom of Panchala, Draupadi is intelligent, spirited, and fiercely independent. However, her life takes a dramatic turn when she is married off to the five Pandava brothers as part of a political alliance. As Draupadi navigates her new role as the wife of five husbands, she grapples with complex emotions and conflicting loyalties. She forms deep connections with each of the Pandavas, particularly Arjuna, but also experiences moments of jealousy and resentment. Despite the challenges of polygamy, Draupadi remains steadfast in her commitment to her husbands and their shared destiny. The novel follows Draupadi's journey through the various trials and tribulations of the Pandavas, including their exile in the forest, their time in hiding, and the infamous game of dice that leads to their eventual exile. Throughout these trials, Draupadi emerges as a beacon of strength and resilience, supporting her husbands through their darkest moments while also standing up for her own rights and dignity. One of the central conflicts of the novel revolves around Draupadi's relationship with Karna, the son of a charioteer who harbors unrequited love for her. Despite their mutual attraction, Draupadi is unable to acknowledge her feelings for Karna due to societal norms and her sense of duty towards her husbands. Their tragic love story adds depth and complexity to the narrative, highlighting the constraints of caste and social status in ancient India. As the novel progresses, tensions between the Pandavas and their cousins, the Kauravas, escalate, leading to the devastating Kurukshetra War. Draupadi plays a pivotal role in the events leading up to the war, using her intelligence and cunning to manipulate political alliances and seek revenge for the injustices committed against her. Throughout the epic battle, Draupadi's strength and courage are put to the test as she witnesses the horrors of war and grapples with the moral implications of violence. In the end, the war culminates in the destruction of countless lives and the triumph of dharma, righteousness, over adharma, unrighteousness, but at a great cost to Draupadi and her loved ones. The Palace of Illusions concludes with Draupadi's reflections on her life and legacy, as she contemplates the cyclical nature of history and the enduring power of storytelling. Through Draupadi's narrative, Divakaruni offers a poignant exploration of themes such as love, loyalty, power, and the quest for justice in a world marked by conflict and uncertainty. Themes: female identity and agency. Divakaruni's portrayal of Draupadi highlights the challenges faced by women in asserting their identity and agency in a patriarchal society. Draupadi's journey is marked by societal expectations, familial obligations, and the constraints of gender roles. Despite these obstacles, she demonstrates resilience and strength as she navigates her own path and confronts the limitations placed upon her by society. Through Draupadi's character, Divakaruni sheds light on the complexities of female identity in the struggle for autonomy in a male-dominated world. Fate versus free will. The novel explores the tension between fate and free will, raising questions about the extent to which individuals can shape their destinies. Draupadi's life is marked by prophecies and divine interventions, yet she continually asserts her agency and strives to make her own choices. Divakaruni presents Draupadi as a character who grapples with the forces of destiny while also actively shaping her own narrative. This theme invites readers to contemplate the nature of fate and the role of individual agency in determining one's destiny. Love and betrayal. Love and betrayal are central themes in the novel, driving the actions of its characters and shaping the course of the narrative. Draupadi's relationships with the Pandavas, particularly her complex bond with Arjuna, are characterized by moments of intimacy, passion, and betrayal. Divakaruni explores the complexities of love and loyalty, depicting the emotional turmoil and moral dilemmas faced by Draupadi as she navigates her relationships with the men in her life. Through these relationships, the novel examines the fragility of trust and the consequences of betrayal in personal and political contexts. War and violence. The novel offers a critical examination of war and violence, particularly in the context of the Mahabharata war. Draupadi's perspective provides insight into the human cost of conflict, highlighting the suffering and loss endured by innocent civilians and combatants alike. Divakaruni portrays the horrors of war with vivid detail, emphasizing the devastating impact of violence on individuals and society. Through Draupadi's experiences, the novel invites readers to reflect on the ethical and moral implications of warfare and the pursuit of power. Ethical dilemmas and moral ambiguity. Throughout the narrative, characters are confronted with ethical dilemmas and moral ambiguity, challenging traditional notions of heroism and villainy. Draupadi grapples with questions of loyalty, justice, and revenge as she navigates the complexities of her relationships with the Pandavas and other key figures in the Mahabharata. Divakaruni presents characters who are flawed and multidimensional, blurring the lines between right and wrong and highlighting the complexities of human morality. This theme prompts readers to consider the ethical implications of individual actions and the consequences of moral ambiguity in times of crisis. Illusion and reality. The title of the novel, The Palace of Illusions, reflects the theme of illusion that runs throughout the narrative. Draupadi's experiences in the palace, where political intrigue and personal drama unfold, serve as a metaphor for the deceptive nature of appearances and the ambiguous boundaries between reality and perception. Divakaruni explores the theme of illusion through Draupadi's interactions with other characters, revealing the hidden truths and underlying motivations that shape their actions. This theme invites readers to question their perceptions of reality and to consider the ways in which illusion can shape human behavior and relationships. The Palace of Illusions, by Chitra Banerjee Divakaruni, offers a captivating retelling of the Mahabharata, one of the two major Sanskrit epics of ancient India. While the original epic is vast and multifaceted, Divakaruni's novel focuses on the life of Draupadi, also known as Panchali, and presents the events of the Mahabharata from her perspective. Here's how The Palace of Illusions serves as a retelling of the Mahabharata narrative perspective. In the Mahabharata, Draupadi is a central character, but much of the narrative is told from an omniscient perspective, focusing on the actions and fates of various characters. Divakaruni's retelling shifts the narrative focus entirely onto Draupadi, offering readers a more intimate and personal exploration of her thoughts, feelings, and experiences. Character development. While the Mahabharata features an extensive cast of characters, The Palace of Illusions delves deeply into Draupadi's character, providing insight into her emotions, motivations, and inner conflicts. Through Divakaruni's portrayal, Draupadi emerges as a complex and multifaceted figure, with her own desires, flaws, and strengths. Exploration of feminine perspectives. One of the most significant departures from the original epic is Divakaruni's emphasis on feminine perspectives. By centering the narrative on Draupadi, the novel offers a feminist reinterpretation of the Mahabharata, highlighting the struggles and agency of its female characters within a patriarchal society. Emotional depth. The Palace of Illusions infuses the Mahabharata narrative with emotional depth, exploring Draupadi's relationships, desires, and vulnerabilities. Divakaruni's prose captures the intensity of Draupadi's emotions, from her love for the Pandavas to her anguish over the injustices she faces. Reinterpretation of key events. While the novel remains faithful to the overarching plot of the Mahabharata, it offers reinterpretations of key events from Draupadi's perspective. For example, the novel provides insight into Draupadi's Swayamvara marriage ceremony, her marriage to the five Pandava brothers, and her role in the infamous game of dice. Exploration of themes. The Palace of Illusions retains many of the thematic elements of the Mahabharata, including themes of duty, honor, power, and destiny. However, the novel also introduces new thematic layers, such as the exploration of female identity, agency, and resilience in the face of adversity. The theme of pride and revenge. The Palace of Illusions explores the themes of pride and revenge as they factor into Panchali's fulfillment of her prophesied fate. Divakaruni notes that, in the mythic and epic tradition, pride and the desire for revenge are qualities of the male hero, which Panchali takes on willingly. And like traditional male heroes, Panchali seeks power. In the end, however, the horrors of the war humble her. She dies anticipating true happiness in the heavenly palace above. Narrator is a participant in a homodigetic narration. Draupadi is a mythical figure that embodies many stereotypes in India. She is often spoken of as being phenomenally beautiful, yet arrogant and hot-headed, and she is seen as the main impetus, the cause, of the war that destroys the Kauravas and many members of the Pandava family as well. Therefore, she is often regarded a Kritya, a being who is jinxed and brings doom. At the same time, she is considered a strong-willed woman, who questions her husband's decisions, especially when she's gambled away in a game of dice, who participates on an equal footing in all their plans and constantly goads them into avenging her humiliation. Her humiliation in the court of the Kauravas after being gambled away by her husband, the eldest Pandava, has also made her an enduring tragic symbol of patriarchal tyranny. And finally, as the shared wife of the five Pandava brothers, she is a rather unique figure in a culture where polygamy was far more prevalent. Therefore, in a version of the Mahabharata retold from her perspective, we expect a re-evaluation of these popular perceptions of Draupadi. We expect to see how she feels about herself, her destiny and her role in the lives of the Pandavas and the Kauravas. And Divakaruni does attempt to give a voice to this narrator as daughter, wife, queen and purveyor of doom. The birth of Draupadi is an important event, at once miraculous and grim. Miraculous because she and brother arise from a sacrificial fire as a boon from the gods in answer to their father's prayers. And grim because she is brought forth solely in order to serve as an instrument in his revenge to bring about the destruction of the Kauravas. In this chapter, an important fact of Draupadi is revealed, her secret and unrequited passion for Karna, and this is not entirely Divakaruni's invention. Many versions of the Mahabharata narrate the silent and scorching passion between the two. In humiliating him at the Swayamvar, she sets off a chain of events that culminates in her own humiliation at the hands of Duryodhana, which in turn brings about the destruction of the Kauravas. Divakaruni portrays Panchali's secret, unfulfilled and illicit love for Karna as her tragic flaw. The writer presents Draupadi as haughty princess who deliberately humiliates Karna by asking him to name his father. Draupadi says that the only reason she had asked his humiliating question was that she did not want her brother to die at the hands of Karna. She admits that her words were ill-chosen and had destroyed any hope of winning his love.